What's going on, guys? Welcome back to a brand new YouTube video. In this video, it's about to be pretty much everything I'm doing on my day off. Tuesdays, Wednesdays, Thursdays, I don't have to work. That's kind of my weekend. So that's why in my last few videos, I haven't been working. I've just been hanging out. So I will show y'all some meals, show y'all a workout, anything else I do today. Basically, I'll just take y'all through my day, get some content out there for y'all to enjoy. Hopefully y'all been watching my other videos. If you haven't, make sure you go back and watch some. Before we get started, these BP shirts, BP apparel. Me and my brothers have a clothing line, if you don't know. First link in the bio or description down below. You can go get you some. Be passionate, be persistent, be powerful. Long sleeves, perfect for winter. Make sure you guys go check it out. All right, y'all. So as you may or may have not seen in my last video, I've been trying to clean up my diet, take it a little bit more seriously. Obviously, powerlifting. I'm burning a lot of calories. I'm putting my body through a lot of load and work. And so I have to make sure that I'm taking care of what I need to outside of the gym, so that I can go in the gym and do the things that I want to. So I'm starting out my first meal. I'm gonna have some chocolate chip Kodiak cakes, and I'm gonna make it with the egg and milk. You can make it with just water as well. These right here, super good. They have high protein, low fat, and a decent amount of carbs as well. So for dieting, these are amazing if you wanna have like a snack or like a something that won't kill your macros, but also helps you have something that tastes good. And then just when you're bulking, we have some normal pancake mix too that I've been using as well. And the macros on it are just a little bit different. You got one fat here compared to three fat. And then 39 carbs and 5 protein compared to 30 carbs on the Kodiak cakes and 14 protein. So 2 more grams of fat, but 3 grams isn't really a lot. And then obviously 9 more grams of protein. So for me, I've been trying to get away from using the protein powder to enhance my protein or get it to where it needs to be, and try to get it as much protein in my diet from foods like this and not protein powder. That's just something I've been trying to do. You could try it if you want to, or you could just scoop some protein powder. Either way, you get it done. As long as you get it done, that's all that matters. All right, y'all, so I got my scale right here. As you may or may not have seen in my last video, everything that I'm eating, I'm basically putting on a scale unless it's easy trackable based on a number amount. So for me, obviously it's gonna take a little bit more time if you put it on a scale, but for me, it's worth it because I'd rather know exactly what's coming in to my body and fueling my workouts. And I'd rather know exactly what's coming in to my body and knowing what's gonna fuel my workouts rather than just rush through it, eat a meal, and then go at the end of the day and be like, dang, I don't even know what I ate, or I don't know how much I ate. So I said earlier that the pancake mix had 14 grams of protein. Obviously, once you add the egg, there's another 9 grams, and that's also another 7 grams of fat. And I'm using whole milk here, so couple grams of fat and couple protein depending on how many ounces I use. So basically I'm just showing y'all, like, you can have a balanced life. You can have foods that you enjoy. You can eat chocolate chip pancakes for breakfast and enjoy them. And you don't have to kill your physique or ruin all your progress just to eat the foods that you like. So there is a lot of times alternatives. A lot of times we know that they don't taste as good or anywhere near what they're supposed to, but these right here, if you check these out, make sure you let me know. I think they taste pretty good for something that's gonna help you out with your macros and take care of your protein needs. Pretty sure y'all know how to make pancakes, I would hope. Basically just pour this mug up in here. Put some cooking spray down. Make sure you get all them chocolate chips. Look at that, we need all that. So, part of the fat in here comes from these chocolate chips, obviously, but like I said before, it's only, with the egg, 10 grams of fat. And I'm not dieting, so adding 10 grams of fat to my breakfast isn't the end of the world. I'll just make sure I watch it later today. I'm not sure what I'll have all in this video. Like I said, I'm just basically going on. Maybe I'll show you all the rest of my meal, maybe not. I kind of did that in my last video. I don't want to get repetitive and boring, but I also want to make sure y'all are seeing content. Make sure I keep on track of myself and my goals for YouTube in 2021 and put out some quality content for y'all. All right, y'all, so here is the finished product. 3 egg whites, 3 sausage links, Kodiak cake. We got Xander working on his bananas over here. So yeah, this will be my pre-workout and first meal of the day. From here, we'll go to the gym, show y'all how I'm working out. Today I have squat and then a few accessories after that. So maybe I'll throw together a little edit. Maybe I'll just throw in the raw clips here. But yeah, let's head to the gym.
Let me see. What about this side? I gotta get both. What about right here? What about right here? What about the other side? Let me see. Where are you going?
All right, just pulled up to the gym. If y'all don't know, Ghost came out with these energy drinks. And this is one of the best flavors, in my opinion, probably number 2. Blue raspberry, Sour Patch Kids. Make sure you guys go check that out. You could get them, if you're in Mankato, at the Hilltop Hy-Vee, or you could get them on the Ghost website. I know they're hard to come by, but I would definitely recommend you try them out. Probably the best energy drink on the market right now.
Oh my God, bro.
So obviously I just finished up that workout. Hopefully you guys like that edit. Recording this before I edit that clip, so hopefully it's good. It's my first time trying something like that, so obviously it'll just get better. So on a squat today, I had a single, and I hit 505. As my coach said, I probably should have capped it there, or 510. But I decided to go for 545, and I hit it with slightly ease. I promise you I could have hit another one, but it was an overshoot for today, and I hit it twice because the first rep of 545, I didn't like the depth, so I wanted to hold myself to a higher standard, and I got back under that and hit it again, which is not the right thing to do if you're powerlifting. Don't ever do that. I know it's wrong, but for me, looking back and looking as if I don't have like a set goal for competition day, not saying that's an excuse, but for me to go back and for my mental to be able to go hit 545 on a second attempt for depth, gives me a lot of self-confidence. And part of lifting, you gotta have that self-confidence when you get under the bar. If you dog yourself or second guess yourself, that's a whole lot of weight to be playing with. So then I hit 405 for my first set of back down, and then I went 390. So the reason I had the back down off the 405 is because I hit that 545. If I would have stayed at 505 or 510 before 545, I guarantee you I would have been able to go over 405 for my back down sets. With those, I had tempo pause, which is never fun, but it is what it is. It comes with being great, it comes with working hard. So I just take what's given to me and keep working. Moving forward, obviously I've been lacking content. I've been thinking of ideas. It's getting kind of boring recording these. I feel like you guys, the people watching, aren't really liking them. It is what it is. It's just like boring everyday stuff. I'm not really doing much. But so what I'm gonna start doing is I have a new idea for a podcast type of interview with people that I already have a plan. I already have a name for it, and I'm gonna start that tomorrow. So you'll see this video by the end of the week for sure, Saturday at the very latest. So make sure you guys are looking out for that. Turn on the post notifications so you get the first alert. Right when I post it, you guys will be let know. And then go down in the comments right now and let me know who you want to see on it. So this is something I can do virtually. This is something that I can do in person. So if you're in Mankato or the area, I can get you on this podcast. If you want to be on it, message me down below or message me on Instagram. Holla at me. Let's do some work and collab. So that's pretty much it, guys. I'm about to go back home. Finish up my day, hang out with Lydia, hang out with Xander, put the camera down and then just enjoy myself, enjoy the moment, and then edit this video. Hopefully it'll be up tonight. If not, it'll be up tomorrow at the latest. So as always, I appreciate you guys checking me out, clicking on this video for a small channel. It means a lot to me, and I hope that you guys enjoyed something, and look forward to seeing the next video. As always, like, comment, share, subscribe. Let your friends know, let your mama know, let your granny know, let your girlfriend know, let your boyfriend know. And they should check out this video, because I think they should. I like to think that I have a bright future ahead of me in this, in powerlifting and social media networking and that kind of thing. So everything helps. I appreciate you guys. See you in the next one.